Welcome to this tutorial for beginners. When you start the software, you have two options: load existing projects and create new projects. I want to open a new project. Let's call it Project 1. Your screen is divided in three sections: the monitor for the preview, the media pool where you will find the effects and many options, and the tracks where you will work on pictures, videos and sounds. Choose timeline mode for your tracks. Go to the menu in the monitor window and select Visible Jog. The jog appeared, and later on you will see how useful it is in this tutorial. To insert a picture in your new project, go to Import, select the one you need, and drag and drop it to the track. Click Play to watch the preview. You can import a picture directly from a folder in the same way. Same thing for a sound or a song. Third example with a video file. Sometimes you will get this pop-up. The resolution of your movie is different than the one of your imported file. For now, choose Do not adjust, and I will explain you why later on in this tutorial. When you import a video, you have the video and the audio on the same track. You can separate them with a right click on the video, audio functions, video and audio on separate tracks. Now you've got the video on track 1 and below the audio on track 2. In the same way, you can remove the audio file from your video. Right-click, Audio Functions, and Remove Audio Object. For example, replace it with a music file. To move your cursor slowly in your video, use the jog. You will move frame by frame in your video. While watching the preview, press key to stop the cursor at the current position. The main shortcuts are undo to cancel the previous action, redo, delete, for example, select an object on the tracks, and click on the shortcut. Title editor, a title appeared in the monitor and on track 4. Double click on your title on track 4 or in the monitor window to change it. You can change the size, the color, etc. The next shortcut is chapter, essential for making a DVD. The shortcuts group and ungroup are important. If you select two objects on the tracks and click on group, they will move together identically. Now click on ungroup, you can move them independently again. Three modes for the mouse. Single, mode for a track, mode for all tracks. Most of the time you will work using single mode. If you choose mode for a track, all the objects on the same track move together. Mode for all tracks. All the objects on all tracks move together. The shortcut stretch. For a picture, you will increase or decrease the number of seconds your picture will appear. In a case of video, bear in mind that you will also change the speed of your video. The next shortcut, split. Choose the right position where you want to split your object and click on the shortcut. Use this function, for example, to delete the part that you don't need in your video. To change the size or position of a picture, same thing for a video or a title, select it on the tracks, go to Effects, Size Position, use the handles and you can easily resize or pivot your picture. You can do it directly on the screen or with the right panel using options such as Rotation or 3D Distortion. To work more easily beyond the dimensions of your movie, go to the options in your monitor window to resize it, for example 75%. In the video effects menu, you will see how to change the color as well. It is essential to understand how the tracks work. The object on track 3, the video in my example, is on top of the object on track 2, which is itself on top of the object on track 1. You will find three options on each track. mute, solo, and lock. Using mute on track 1, the selected track is not played. Using mute on track 1 and on track 3, the two tracks are not played. Using solo on track 3, for example, only this track is played. If you use lock on track 1, you can't make any change to any of the objects on track 1. I'm trying to move it or delete it. As you can see, it's impossible. I'm going to show you keyframes using a very basic example. I want the video to start from position A and to be at position B 10 seconds later, and to end at position C. Select your video and place your cursor on the timeline at the beginning of your video. In the monitor window, place your object at the position A. Go to Effects, Size and Position, and click on Create a new keyframe. Now move your cursor to 10 seconds on the timeline, place your video at position B in the monitor window, go to Effects, Size Position, and create a new keyframe. Once again, move your cursor on the timeline at the right position, and move your video in the monitor window. Go to Effects, Size Position, and create a keyframe. And let's watch the result. The Chromakey effect is fun to use. First example with this video of a young boy on a scooter in front of a green background. This video is on track 2. Select the video, go to Effects, Video Effects, and Chromakey. Click on the green button. All the green in my video has disappeared. Adjust the threshold if you need to. Now you can insert another video, place it on track 1, so it becomes a background for your first video. Second example with two pictures. Place the first one on track 2, go to Effects, Chromakey. You could click on the blue button to make the blue sky disappear, but you can use this button Color. In this case, select the color in the monitor window that should become transparent. Adjust the threshold. As before, insert a picture or a video on track 1 to turn it into a background for your first picture. To add a fade-in effect, use the first handle. In the same way, create a fade-out effect with the last handle. Previously in this tutorial, we had this alert when we wanted to import a video on the track. The resolution of your movie is different than the one of your imported file. I would recommend you click on Do Not Adjust because you don't want to change the resolution of your project every time you import a file with a different resolution. When you want to export your project as a video, click on the Export button. Choose Output as Video File. Choose the quality and the format. Give a name to your video and save. During the export, you can have a look at the preview. Depending on your project and how powerful your computer is, the export process may take a very long time. Be careful when you choose this export option, as the export will be from the first file to the last one found on the tracks. So don't forget to delete all the files not used in your project. When you don't want to export your whole movie but only a range, select the position on the timeline where the export must begin and click on Start of Range. Same thing for the end and click on End of the Range. You will notice that your range appears in blue. Go to File, Export Movie, choose the format, choose the name and where you want to save your video. And don't forget to tick the box Export selected, range only. You now have the two videos that you have exported in your file. Don't forget to regularly click on Save and go to File, Save Project As to create a backup of your project under a different name. If you have modified the software windows too many times and you want to go back to a previous layout, first don't forget to save your project, then go to File, Settings, Reset Program Settings to Default. The program will restart and bring back the default settings. I hope you found this tutorial useful, and if you did, please like it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. For those who already have, thank you for your support. Have fun and see you soon!